It shows we are live on Facebook. Welcome everyone who's on Facebook to the ABCD show. I'm trying to check my phone as well. Are we live?
Yes, I can see it's showing the indication is that we are live.
Yes.
And people are coming in.
Okay, that's nice.
So wonderful, everyone. Start introducing yourself when you come in. Tell us who you are. Tell us what you're expecting from this topic. Have you heard Dr. Seema Negi earlier? Are you a member of the ABCD Thought Leaders group?
Yes, and if you are not a member, the link is posted in the chat. Please become a member. Thank you.
Hi, Rupali.
Hi, Jyotsna. Rupali, you can mention from which school also you are, even Jyotsna. Oh, very good. Seema Negi is very, very famous. Many people have heard you also. That's nice.
Hi, Usha.
Usha Rani.
Usha Rani.
Nice to see you. Thanks, Rupali, for mentioning your school's name. I'm Meenakshi. Hi, Gayatri and Dimple. Nice having you over.
Have you all attended the ABCD show earlier? Is this your first time? Oh, lovely, Jyotsna. Hi, Inderpreet. Okay, so Gayatri and Jyotsna coming here for the first time. Wonderful. Hi, Manisha. You're not an ABCD member. You can just become one by going to the link and becoming a member.
As simple as that.
Hi, Anurag Shri.
Oh, Arundhati Anand is here.
How are you?
Nice to see you.
Thanks,
hi, Dimple.
Dimple.
I wonder who NMH is, but hi.
So, Manisha, we put up a link in the chat box. So if you scroll up the chat box, you'll see the first link over there and you can just go and become a member. And when you become a member, the point is to contribute and the point is to see other people's contribution. So please go, please actively participate in the Thought Leaders group because all of us are thought leaders.
I've added the link again down for those to make it easy. ABCD Thought Leaders group. The link is mentioned down. Welcome. And hope to see you in the group soon. Veena, it's your first time, but glad you joined us. I hope you have a lot of takeaways from Seema's talk today.
I'm sure she will.
Yes.
We have a YouTube link. We also have all our all the episodes on Facebook. So you can go to the ABCD show page and then view anything or go to our YouTube link. Mila, you can put up a YouTube link also if it's handy.
All the links are posted. Do you want me to post it again?
I think they can just watch the shows they've missed.
Sure.
Hi, Durga.
Yeah, there goes all the links on the chat.
Wonderful.
Please like and subscribe to our channel as well. And would love to hear your comments so we know what more people expect from us. And we hope to live up to your expectations as well.
Yeah, tell us if you want any particular speakers. Tell us if you want us to talk on any particular topic. Let's start some rich discussions on the thought leaders group so that all of us can participate, all of us can help each other learn.
And one thing you must remember, learning only happens once you start asking questions. So be free to ask questions on the group and we'll be happy to answer. In fact, all of the people who are going to be in the group, all thought leaders, so when they can answer and, you know, help each other grow in that community.
Proper co-construction, no?
Yes.
Bela, Dr. Seema, this is co-construction. We're all helping each other.
True. Hi, Amina.
I think
we should not waste other people's time. Yes, they do not have to be punctual.
Yes, and I think I'll start with sharing Bela and my introduction. So.
Sure.
I'm Amrita Rajpal. I've been teaching for 22 years, but I've been learning my whole life, and that's why I have a company called Edu Learn Grow. I'm a sports nutritionist. I'm an avid traveler, and I'm an active Rotarian. I'm also the territory head for the Early Childhood Association, Mumbai. I'm founder Edu Learn Grow and co-founder the ABCD Show.
Hi. I'm Bela Kotwani, also known as Big B. Big for the size of my heart and B for Bela. A fun-loving person with a great sense of humor and a passionate pickleball player. National Core Committee member of Early Childhood Association, founder and principal of Cosmic Kids International, co-founder Puppet Maestros, and co-founder The ABCD Show. The ABCD Show is a show where everything concerned with children is addressed.
We're going to get in eminent experts whose opinions matter. We're going to introduce you to new products. We're going to have theories unfold into practice. We'll discuss mental health and wellness. We'll look at best practices. We'll give you parenting tips and we'll explore tools and strategies to help you teach effectively.
So, if you are a preschool coordinator, parent, teacher, or anyone who has anything to do with children, this show is for you.
So don't forget to like our page to know more about our upcoming events.
Oh, thank you, Veena and Jyotsna, for joining the group. And now we are getting back to our topic. Our topic today is from puddle to ocean learning through different learning landscapes. My God, this is such an interesting topic, and I'm sure every educator over here is just about waiting to hear more about it. And for this topic, we have an expert speaker that we have here. And for the ones who don't know Dr. Seema Negi, I'm privileged to introduce her. So Dr. Seema Negi is a global goodwill ambassador. She's an edu leader, and she's the principal of Sanjeevani World School with more than 2 decades of experience across Indian and international boards. She's the coordinator for SAARC Nations Regional Committee for the Global Youth Parliament. She's an advisor for the Sports Academy Association of India. She's the Secretary General from India for Global Talk Education. And she's the Territory Head for Association for Primary Education and Research, APER. And she's a proud Rotarian and a social ambassador for the Indian Development Foundation. So we have a lot of things in common, Dr. Seema. I'm a proud Rotarian too. I'm also the secretary of my Rotary Club. So wonderful. In addition, she's an eminent speaker. She's a moderator. She's a panelist. And she's done this at various summits and global platforms. So she's also the recipient of many national, international awards. And she takes great pride in training teachers to balance out between technology-driven and value-based education. And she feels that children should be prepared for life and not for exams. So wonderful. Welcome, and thank you for coming on our show.
Thank you so much. Welcome, it's my proud privilege. Thank you, Bela. Thank you, Amrita. Yes. It's such a wonderful platform, and I see a lot of the Facebook updates and the links that you provide me on regular basis without fail, and they stimulate a different kind of learning. And I think that is what we all are looking for. And it was only your videos that you have sent made me come up with a very, very different topic, and the topic from hill to ocean. So we are going to discover, or invent, or pack a toolbox, or what? Let's see. Time will tell. So lovely. Do we start?
Yes, lovely. We can. And yes, please feel free to share your screen, and
yes,
you can take it forward from here.
So thank you, Amrita. Thank you, Bela. And good evening, all the wonderful people who have joined us from Panin, as I was reading your school. So you have joined us from everywhere. And I simply hope that by the end of this particular session, we all will learn from each other, because it's not going to be a passive session where I'll be presenting the monologue and you will be a passive listener. What you have to do is you have to keep on writing whatever you feel like in the chat box, and there will be small triggers I'll give you. So your mind needs to work forever while you are listening. Okay, so let's see how beautifully we do that. You are preschool educators. You have dealt with thinking heads. You have dealt with doing hands. You have dealt with feeling heart also. Now we don't have to leave the dancing feet. So let's take the dancing feet to puddle and just move away. So as we all know, the education landscapes are constantly changing. We all are aware of that. And each one of you have just jumped into it with this pandemic. And there is nothing that you have not done to reach to your children. So few of the slides are a little bit of gyan, which you all know. But I'll tell you why this gyan is needed later to connect with what we are going to discuss. So learner needs to thrive in an uncertain world. Till now, we used to say, okay, we have to prepare our children for uncertain future. It's said and done. They are ready for uncertain future. A pre-primary child, a three-year-old child, a five-year-old child, confined to his or her house, not telling the parents that they want to go out, they want to have pizza, they want to do this thing. They are confined and they are listening to what their teachers are telling when the screens are coming alive for you. So they are prepared for the uncertain world. Now we have to change our way of thinking and preparing them for something which is beyond this uncertainty. So we need to change, and we need to create a 21st century learning environment with 22nd century mindset. Because till now we say we have to prepare children for 21st century. When we are talking about it from ages, from last 10 years, just pick up any book, just go to any seminar. Everybody talks about 21st century. But what is our mindset? Our mindset is to...
Seema, I think we've lost you. Amrita, can you hear?
No, is she frozen for you all too?
Please write in the chat box so we all know.
Yes, she's frozen.
Okay.
I think we may have...
Seema, can you maybe...
Maybe may have a 21st century mindset, but 22nd century mindset, but we have a 21st century internet for sure. We are just dependent on this.
Yes, the screen is frozen. Maybe she'll get back in sometime. She's just logged off. And I'm sure she'll join back soon. Yes. This is what technology does. We are so handicapped with technology.
Yeah. Correct. So till she comes back, I want to ask you all, what do you all think is the 21st century mindset?
Please type it in the comment box.
Yeah. What do we think in when we talk box. About 21st century mindset? What does growth mindset mean to you? Okay, open to all situations.
Accepting challenges, yes.
Technology oriented, more adaptable.
Without fear, soaring high, yes. And when you fall down, get up and rise again and up.
Totally resilient.
Flexible, adaptable, yes.
Aren't we doing it right now? We are accepting uncertainties. This was something we didn't expect.
Yes. And go with the flow. Very rightly said.
So there is a term also
called willpower to overcome.
There's a term called cognitive flexibility. You know, and if you go to see, that is exactly what we require. Okay, you're back.
I was thrown out that this technology, see?
Yes. We were just discussing, we can have 22nd century mindset, but we have 21st century internet. Yes.
So that's the biggest problem. Now, let me go to screen share again. And here we go. So this happens at times. So what
do you want to put off your video while you're talking if your internet is low?
Do that. I mean, now I have come to the hotspot.
Yeah. Oh, perfect.
I thought that was the better option. Now, what we are going to discuss today is we are going to discuss about how to move from puddle to ocean and how different learning landscape will make it easy for each one of us. So from ABC, which, I have not written the D because D always stands for drama for me, because you have to create a lot of drama when you are dealing with pre-primary learners. So from Amrita Bela collaboration, from attitude, behavior, character, adaptability, bravery, and capacity, because each one of you are capable of many things and you need to be brave to go ahead with the change. Today, we are going to go to OIP. That is ocean of infinite possibilities, because infinite possibilities is what each one of you possess. The only thing is you do not introspect. You see the situation from the same angle. Now, today, throughout the day when we are together or for an hour, you have to think that you are a 22nd century learner and think from a different perspective. So what we have to do is, our puddle stands for prepare yourself to dive down to learnability environment. Next 30 minutes, we are in an environment which is full of learnability. We are learning from each other. In between, you want to unmute and you want to say something which will add to everybody's learning. Please do that. And what does our ocean stand for? Our ocean stands for outlook to be changed. I mean, to change yourself, to emerge as another new. So after this ABCD show, which happens every time you emerge as a new learner, today again, you have to do this thing that you will emerge as a new learner. Something you need to add to your learning, that's very important. Now, learners reshape learning landscapes, new directions, old challenges. See, everything that you will come across will be old challenge. Same challenge will be there, that your small child is coming to school and the child has some difficulty, or you want to do sand play with the child, you want to, make the child learn the alphabet. The challenges will be same. But what is the new approach? You have to try out that new approach. So childhood is that state which ends the moment a puddle is first viewed as an obstacle instead of an opportunity. So what happens when we see that our small child is there with us, and rather than letting the child be in his or her own natural environment, when we start putting the child in the box, what we do, we turn that puddle as an obstacle rather than making it as an opportunity. So let your children jump, let your children play, let them dirty their hands. I think everywhere, wherever you will go, every time for early educator, it has been said that let the children explore the things that the way they want to, because for the child, puddle is the first step to learn. Now you must be thinking how it is the first step to learn. When we teach our children water cycle, then again we tell them about puddle. When the child comes out of the house during a rainy season, the child might not see gushing of water, but the child might come across puddle. So take that puddle as curiosity. So your puddle can be curiosity generator. From where you can take the child from that puddle, can you take the child to the ocean? How many of you, you will reflect for a minute, how many of you see a mud puddle and think of a big ocean with a ship? How many of you? You can write in the chat box. Do you do that? Mm-hmm. If you do that, then I can very well say that you are a visionary person and you have a growth mindset. A child comes to you like a small puddle, a known person, and you see the infinite possibilities. That is your mightiest ocean. Have you done that? If you have done that, write in the chat box that when a child comes, you see the infinity. What happens if a child comes to nursery and you sit with the parents for PTM? You tell parents about what the child has learned in nursery and what the child will learn in nursery. Now, let's change things. Let's think from 22nd century mindset. When a parent sits with you to know about nursery, tell a parent about what the child will get after the child will pass out from school. Show them the bigger picture. Trust me, it will help you convert your admissions also during the time of admission. And parents will be ready for something which is uncertain, which we have already discussed that, okay, we have to prepare our children for uncertain, a very difficult future. Show the parents a bigger, a mightier ocean wherein lot of infinite possibilities are there. Do not restrict a nursery child or a pre-primary child to a small puddle only. Small puddle is a closed box. We have to come out of that. Again, every path has its own puddle. How many puddles have you crossed? You might have crossed many puddles. These puddles are your small learning milestone. You might have, during this pandemic, you might have attended so many workshops and you might have gained. And sometimes you might have felt, okay, I know this thing. Because this is what we do as an educator. Most of the time we feel, okay, this is what I know. But do we see each and every workshop from a different perspective? Maybe this picture wherein a child is crossing the puddle, can you think of something which is beyond this? Can you think that when you will let your children do this thing, you can tell them about tadpoles, you can tell them about frogs, you can tell them about fishes, you can tell them about water cycle, you can tell them about everything. That is infinite possibility. Are you taking your children there? That is a big question you have to keep on asking throughout this presentation, because the slides are minimum. I will quickly finish the slide and then we will come to the real discussion. So in a puddle, ask for a pool. In a pool, ask for a lake. In a lake, ask for an ocean. This is the way to embrace infinity. Have you done that? If you get a small thing, I mean, you know, when what happens if suppose we get a small gift, we always think of a bigger gift. When we get a little big gift, we think, okay, we should get the biggest gift. So we think about those things. Then why not when a child comes to us like a raw puddle, we think of, okay, let me work out on the child and then take it from pool to lake to ocean. Again, I always associate ocean to infinity. It is mighty. An ocean is not just a body of water. Now think about ocean. When we think about ocean, what all comes to your mind? The cruise liners will come to your mind. The mighty ships will come to your mind. The marine life will come to your mind. But I want each one of you to become the lighthouse when you think of ocean. So when you become lighthouse, then without judging anyone, you are there for that person, whether it's parent or it's your colleagues or it's your teacher or it's your students, because then you will be there selflessly. Try to become that lighthouse. Not easy. Let me tell you, it is not easy. We all are human. We all have our own way of thinking, our high moments, low moment, everything. And we know the kind of PTMs we conduct sometimes. So what you have to do, PTMs are your time when you become the true lighthouse and give and give and give. You are a teacher. You are a chosen one. So you need to know the art of giving. So that's important. So what we need to focus on is focus on the ocean of positivity, not the puddle of negativity. Now, when you see there is always a fight in our own brain about positive thinking and negative thinking. If you start thinking about some negativity since from the morning, or if you go to a class with the mindset that today I have to conduct this activity, but I don't have the resource, I don't know how I'll be doing, or I have to conduct an activity in front of the screen, how I'll do, I don't have chart papers, I don't have this, I don't have that, that puddle of negativity can turn to the ocean of negativity. So never let it happen. Always ensure then you, when you think about positivity, it has to be ocean. And when the negative component is there, it has to be as small as puddle. So the mighty ocean will take over the puddle. And that is what an educator or a learner or a 22nd century thinker who wants to bring a change needs to go ahead with. So it's not the sea that draws you. It's the puddle. You know, it's all your mindset. It's all your mindset, which is very fixed. This cannot happen this way. Okay, if the child is ADHD, I won't be able to teach the child in a particular manner. Okay, if the child is not making the curves proper, that means the child will not be able to write the letters properly. So it's all the small, small things that are there in our mind, or the fixed mindset. Again, I'll come to that, that we feel, okay, the children are born with certain kind of talents and abilities. And those who do not have these talents and ability, this cannot be taught. No, this is the time to move to growth mindset. Everything, whether it's attitude or it's skill or it's behavior or it's habit, can be reworked on. And you are the one who play the major role in that. You know, after grade 10 examination, when children succeed, they get good grades, and always grade 10 teachers are felicitated for that. I believe that is the time a pre-primary teacher should be felicitated first, because you are the one who are laying the first brick. So see how important are you. If you do not lay the first brick properly, the building is not going to stand. So you are the one whose impression from a child's life can never be erased, whether it is recognized or it is not recognized, but it cannot be erased, because you are the mighty ocean. Now, in the waves of change, we find true direction. Today is the wave of change. Today is the wave of change where you have reached to a student's house and parents have reached to your house. Are you able to collaborate during this wave of change? Take this wave of change as an opportunity to collaborate with parent. If suppose you have seen the mother is sitting with the child, and maybe during the munch time, if the parent has made something very nice and very healthy, later on you can have the conversation with parent. I was so happy the way you were feeding your child, or the dish that you had made looks so amazing. I also want something like that for my child. You know, build that connect. This is the right time to build the connect. The same thing can be done during the regular school hours also. Build that connect. Come and talk beyond academics. There is so much beyond academics. A child is not just numeracy and literacy. A child is more of play, play, play. And play is what is the best way to learn. And trust me, when the schools will open, I think each one of you need to focus more on play rather than all our teaching things. Let them play, and everything can revolve around that. Many of the big Fortune 500 companies and Fortune 1000 companies, they are not looking for the mark sheet now. They are looking for the skills, and these skills are developed right from our kindergarten. So again, I'm telling you, you are the mighty ocean. But what happened? We as teachers, as grown-up adults, we become a person who never jump on the puddle, but we try to go from one side of the puddle. And that is when we lose the child who was inside us. That is when we do not understand our children from their perspective. So what we need to do is, let's pack a toolbox, okay? So the toolbox is here, I say. You stand in a puddle when I give you an ocean. So imagine each one of you standing in a puddle in that limited space, okay? With a limited amount of water around. But here I want to give you the ocean. Now this ocean is mighty. This ocean has, as I told you, marine life. This ocean has a big a cruise liner. This ocean has a yacht, lighthouse, everything. So let's start packing our toolbox. So imagine each one of you have your toolbox in your hand and a child comes to you. Okay, what is the first possibility that you see? Now you are no more in the fixed mindset. You are in a growth mindset. You are a person who understands the child very well because you have seen from puddle to ocean. You have seen from known to abstract, from limited to infinite, from one to many. So what is the first thing that you will pack in your toolbox? Anyone who can write. What is the first thing that will come to your toolbox? So I think I will just close it and then we can discuss about the toolbox. So to all the lovely audience who is sitting and watching this, this is on a lighter note. Never give your heart to anyone. It must be earned. Don't let them walk over a puddle. Make them cross the ocean. So you are so very important. Do not consider yourself as a simple pre-primary teacher or just a teacher. You are the one who makes the society. You are the one who makes the nation. You are the one who whose contribution towards the entire world is immense. So here, the puddle in me bows down to the ocean in you because, again, as I told you, you have the strength. I, as an educator, feel that I am a small puddle. And I have to learn from the ocean that is there inside you because each one of us have a mighty ocean inside us. And that is what we need to unveil. And that is how we are going to prepare our toolbox now. Now let's come to our toolbox. So if suppose a child comes, let's come to a situation. A child has come to our school or there are many children in our kindergarten and we need to become the mighty ocean. Now we need to become a person who is ready to collaborate with everyone, ready to collaborate with all the parents, ready to collaborate with co-colleagues. So again, four tools I will give you, five tools before we move ahead and you will pack your toolbox. One is you have to, while preparing the toolbox, you have to look beyond. Look beyond what you see. So when you look beyond what you see immense creativity everywhere, immense creativity. And then you have to look around also. And when you look around here, there, everywhere, you will see everybody is ready to collaborate. So we will see which tool we are packing for collaboration. You have to at the same time look within. Because when you will introspect, you will come to know that entire ocean lies here. Immense possibilities. Why we never brought it out? Why somebody has to come and say that, okay, it's time to bring it out. You can do it on your own because that intrinsic drive is very essential. Then you have to look deep. It is very important when you look deep, you critically start evaluating the situation and you start asking questions to your own self. So just to give you a very small example, Abraham Lincoln's mother taught him the art of asking intelligent questions. It is very important to ask intelligent questions and let the children ask. More the wise, the better the learner. And last but not the least, look up. Because when you look up, you see the sky. Sky is again mighty and infinite. Draw your energy from there. Draw that positivity from there because it will give you a lot of positivity. It has been said in a Sanskrit phrase, yad bhav tad bhavati. The way you think, so shall be. So let's prepare our toolbox. All of us are sitting with our toolbox. We have it ready. Okay, this is a beautiful box. Whichever color you like, pink, blue, red, you can have the toolbox with this color. What will be the first tool that comes to your mind when we say we have moved from a limited puddle to a mighty ocean? We are the one who know everything, like infinite, but still we have to learn infinite because ocean is something which you cannot see entire ocean together. you will see horizon, but you will there is still ocean which you cannot see. So yes, we have learned what is needed. We have seen so many ABCD show, right? So every time we learn. So let's gather all our learning and be a learner. So what is the first tool that you will pick? Let me see. I will know the child first. Empathy, very good. But how do we know the child? Yes, we will know the child, but for knowing the child, what is the tool? There should be a tool to know the child. Communication. Okay, communication, we all do. So when a pre-primary parent, give the hand off a 3-year-old child or say a 2.5-year-old child, extend a hand to your hand, how do you feel? How do you feel? Have you felt that moment? That is not just communication, connectivity, teaching. That is the responsibility. How many of you have packed your toolbox with responsibility? Take the responsibility. Parents have trusted you, and with that trust, that responsibility is given to you. Take that responsibility. So when you take that responsibility, you become responsible for that child's entire life, because what you will teach to the child in that particular grade, again, I'm telling you, that will be the biggest brick on which other things will be laid. So let's pack responsibility. Moving ahead, we have packed responsibility. What is the next thing we have to pack in a toolbox? You have taken responsibility. So after taking responsibility, Shape their life. After taking responsibility, what we have to do? After taking responsibility, we have to be willing to see that the change happens. Then we need to collaborate with parents. The willingness again comes from inside. Nobody can put it inside you. See, when you attend any motivational talk, you get motivated for a particular amount of time or a period of time. Then you come back to your mundane life. What is needed is that intrinsic drive. Again, I'll tell you. So come here. Come to the head. We talk about head, heart, and hands. So come to the head. Everything lies here. Trust me, everything lies here. So if everything is set here, you can do everything. So you have to start believing that I am the mind. I am the mind. And if I am set, everything is set. That is what I have to do. And the willingness comes automatically. Responsibility you have taken, but if you are not willing, then that responsibility cannot be fulfilled. Let's have our toolbox with responsibility, with willingness, and then try to become the lighthouse. Compassion is must. Without compassion and empathy, we cannot move ahead. Then try to become a lighthouse. Now, why did I say that all the teachers are lighthouse? Because you are not biased about a certain child or any children. You try to teach them in the similar manner. So there are incidences where teachers are biased, but then we have to, grow up from that. We are teachers. Never forget that teacher is not something that anybody can be a teacher. No. Teaching is something which God has chosen you to do this thing. No, everybody cannot teach. Otherwise, during this pandemic, we have seen that everything has turned into digital. Why do we need teachers? There are robots teaching. There are YouTube videos. Everything is there. But what you can do, neither a whiteboard can do nor a blackboard can do. So whether it's whiteboard or it's blackboard, the magic can be done by you only. It's you. So when you're packing your toolbox, pack your expressions. It's not just your mouth who is doing the talking. It's your entire body who is doing the talking for the child. So the screens come alive when your body talks. So along with your head, hands, and heart, I said your dancing feet also need to be there. So as a whole package, pack yourself as a lighthouse who will always be there to guide, come what may. So you will be there to guide. Then comes empathy. Yes, understand the child from child's perspective. It is so important that we have to say A for apple when we know A for so many things are there, A for, but still we stick ourselves or we are just stuck to the, traditional approach, we say A for apple. Right now also, if I'll tell everyone, okay, I'll ask you a question and A for, half of us will say apple. We are conditioned that way. Why don't we come out? Now, let me take you with a drawing from puddle to ocean. Now the puddle is, suppose you have your nursery child and you want to teach coloring to your child. Okay. So what happens mostly when we talk about a very traditional method, we give a paper to a child, okay, and we draw any figure. So we might draw any figure and we tell the child to scribble, right? We do that. We tell the child to scribble so that, okay, red color, blue color. Now, this is a small puddle we have given to our child and our child is just scribbling and we think, okay, and as a very neat and tidy teacher, because we want the work to be very neat, we tell the child that the color should not go out of the boundary, right? And as a parent also we do, as a teacher also we do. Now, let's change the approach. 22nd century teachers, we are, right? We, our approach is more broader. It's as huge as ocean. Give the page to your child, give the color and say, okay, just scribble. Let 30 children in your class scribble and then take the color and draw the boundary. Everybody's ocean is different. Everybody is a different child. Each and every child is a distinct and different individual. Why do we restrict them to the small puddle of life? Why we do not let them explore the infinite ocean? Again, this ocean lies in you. And it does not need Mahagyan. It does not need big books. No, it just needs your moment of enlightenment when you get connected to the child and feel, yes, this is my responsibility. I have to take the responsibility further. And I'm willing to do it come what may. This pandemic has shown the world that teachers were willing to do it. That willingness came because we were very reluctant to use technology. Zoom, Google Meet, this, that, who? We were never ready for that. But when we were thrown to that, trust me, all of us have learned swimming. And swimming to, again, a very, very infinite vasty, because by the time we think, okay, we have learned the swimming and we are in the pool expert, a lake comes. Lake, then a river comes. Then this ocean, and we are learning and we are learning. And it has become continuous. We are not stopping. That is why for this day, you were made teacher. Yes, embrace the uncertainty. Uncertainty is what we have embraced it so well, so well. And again, I say, like, I usually teach bigger children, but the one who is teaching the pre-primary classes or the elementary learners, that is the most difficult task. It is very easy to teach a grade 10 child, grade 12 child. Trust me. I have taught right from nursery to grade 12. It is very easy to teach senior children. Most difficult work of this world is to teach pre-primary children. Trust me, it is very difficult and you are doing a commendable job. The connect that you get with the child, that is a connect parents look for. Parents come to you and say, "Hamari nahi sunta, aapki sunega, aap bolo, mobile nahi dekhe." That is the kind of respect you get. Sometimes you do not get that respect in senior class because they just see marks. Their parents just see marks. Here, parents see their child coming home and being happy. Happiness is what is needed when it comes to pre-primary classroom. So again, let's move ahead. Let's not deviate from the topic because that's very interesting. Again, have you thinking something which is beyond? So then we will go to the journey of going beyond. Again, a small example I'll give you. So for example, if I tell you this is Apple iPhone, but do not consider it as iPhone. Consider this is a red color apple. So if I'm showing you a red color apple, what will come to your mind? And if I'll tell you to, okay, now it's time to look deep and think deep. Now you have, from a puddle approach, if you will see it, you will become like an ant. You know, when an ant talks about sea or ocean, basically the ant is talking about a puddle. Okay, because from that lens ant sees. Now I'm showing you this from the lens of a person who is empowered, who is a thinker, who is a change maker. So I am showing you a red color apple and I'm asking you to think deep and tell me, what do you see beyond this red color apple? What comes to your mind? Color of an apple is white. Color of an apple can be white. Yes, from inside. That's right. What else? An apple a day keeps the doctor away. Okay, that's again, we all know the doctors are doing a wonderful job. What else?
Orchard, are we seeing germination?
Yes.
Are we seeing all those concepts of plants?
Wonderful. You see the fully grown orchard. So with one apple, if you can see the fully grown orchard, you have seen something which is beyond. So we have to see that beyond. We have to see that infinity. We have to see that limitless possibility. So what you are doing, you are taking your children from a known knowledge to an abstract knowledge and building on that. Sometimes we feel that smaller children are too young to do any experimentation or to learn how to hypothesize and then how to come to the conclusion. Just go to them and ask. Just see how, I mean, they are an asset to become a think tank, because their whys will have all our questions, all our answers. And these whys are very important. At times, we do not develop the art of questioning, which is again one of a very, very important art, because your communication depends upon that. It is not about asking questions, but then there are rhetorical questions. You need to ask your own self, are we preparing our learners for that? That is something that you have to do. They are very curious. Yes, they are very curious, Jyotsna. That is right. And that curiosity leads to learning. That curiosity leads to a bigger, mightier ocean. And that is what is needed. Now, again, coming back to collaboration, what we were talking, since we understood our child, we have shown the larger picture to our parents. We have understood how to move out from a puddle approach of seeing things in the minimalistic way to going to the infinite way. How do we collaborate with parent? Because usually when we talk about PTMs are sometimes tug of the war kind of thing. Okay, this parent, that teacher. So it happens. Now imagine your PTM wherein you want to collaborate with your parent. And when the parent comes, you tell the parent, I am so the way you have taught your child at home, see the curves that when the child writes, and I'm sure you are doing a lot of hard work with your child. And you just see after that the way parents will behave with you. And if there will be thousands of queries they will have, they will mellow down. So PTM needs to be the day when we celebrate empathy and gratitude. Have your PTM nicely garnished with empathy and gratitude and see the change. Trust me, it's words which create magic. So have an ocean of words with you. Positive words which can create magic and which can create wonders. Giving you an analogy of Jagannath Puri Rath Yatra. I do it very often because that's one of my favorite when it comes to collaboration. I don't know how many of you have witnessed Jagannath Puri Rath Yatra, but that is the only religious procession wherein God and goddesses are, I mean, worship as brother and sister. So we have Lord Krishna, Balram and Subhadra who sit on the chariot. And there are two group of people. One group of people who pull the chariot, second group of people who cheer them. Because, you know, cheerleaders have a lot of importance. So what you have to do is you have to imagine your children are sitting on the chariot. And when you are pulling the chariot, please tell your parents, when we as teachers are or we as school are pulling the chariot, you cheer for us. And when you will pull the chariot, we will cheer for you. It is not difficult.
Lovely.
So the thing is, thank you so much. So the thing is, we need to break that barrier, because behind a child stands two very important institutions. One is school, one is family. There cannot be any invisible line behind between them. The more the invisible line is, the difficult it is for us to make a child an asset to the society. That is why I always say a nursery child, you have to show the parent what the child will get after grade 12. Show infinity, come out of that puddle approach and go to the ocean approach of infinity, limitless possibility. Every morning, if you can just look up at the sky, because you can't go to look up at the ocean every time, but just look up at the sky and draw your positive energy from the universe. Trust me, it will change. It will change your entire perspective, because you will think about positivity, and the positivity, you have to make the positivity grow so much that it becomes again like your ocean, not like your puddle. So whenever you think negative, go to puddle. When you think positive, go to ocean and let it grow, let it grow, let it grow, and let it multiply. So I would like some of the audience to please tell something. Now they were preparing their toolbox also. I gave them three things, but apart from that, what all they have put. So we know responsibility is there. We know willingness is there. We know empathy is there. Compassion is there. What all you have packed, how full your toolbox is now. And yes, you became lighthouse. That's important. So what all is flexibility? Yes, flexibility is needed. You can't be rigid. What else have we packed in our toolbox? Trust is very important. But then trust is a two-way sword at time. It is good to trust, but don't be a blind follower of things. Be very careful. Might not be the right platform, but since we are talking to pre-primary teachers, it is very important when a child comes and tells you something, a very scary, but a story which is needed. A nursery child went to the teacher and told that, teacher, my uncle licked my cookie. So teacher heard and said, okay, next time tell uncle not to lick your cookie. That's fine. And days passed and the child started becoming gloomy and gloomy and gloomy and started going to her own shell. So after almost 40 days, there was BTM and mother came and she discussed that my child is not very much interested in many things these days. And the child is just out. I mean, just don't want to be in touch with anyone, doesn't want to talk to friends, doesn't want to play. And so the teacher, all of a sudden, this incident came to the teacher's mind. And she said that, she was very disturbed. One day she came and told me that my uncle licked my cookie. And post that, I have always seen the child very, very sad. And that was the moment mother realized what a big mistake she has done. We as educator, we feel that we don't have to, we name things, okay? We don't tell which body part is what. We name things. So we don't have to. We have to tell. We have to tell everything. If we can say face is face, we have to tell vagina is vagina. We don't do that. And the child was molested. So
God.
We have to be very, very particular. That is why when a child says something, look for what can be beyond that. Beyond that. We cannot say our body part, this is cookie, this is toffee, this is that. No. We have to tell them the right thing and be ears for your children because you wrote trust. So the child came to the teacher with a lot of trust and the child thought that, yes, my teacher will listen to me. But the teacher did not look beyond. So look beyond. That's important. That is why I say the approach of our being confined to our puddle, gone are the days. I mean, we are not 19th century teacher. We are not 20th century teacher. We are not 21st century teacher. Start thinking from 22nd century teacher. In fact, if we go back, I think we had much empowered teachers when we come to a Gurukul system. See, we always talk about Finland. We talk about Japan. We talk about Nordic nation. But how many of us have really reflected back and seen how beautiful our education system was? So come back to your motherland. I mean, do research here and see how empowered you will become. Because again, it is you who can be the change. It's again said very beautifully in Sanskrit, Tat Parivartan Bhava. You need to be the change. Are you ready to be the change? So if you are ready to be the change, infinity is waiting for you. The mighty ocean is waiting for you. But if you are not ready to come out of your fixed mindset, nobody can push you to growth mindset. If you want to be an educator of tomorrow, today, you are doing wonderful. But if you want to be an educator of tomorrow and an educator of of future, you need to come out of this particular mindset and go for infinity. I'm using this word again and again because infinity doesn't limit you to anything. It doesn't limit your thinking. It doesn't limit your learning. It doesn't limit your creativity. It doesn't limit your collaboration. By the time you feel, okay, I have seen 16 episodes of ABCD, I know everything. The 17th episode will bring some magic. And you will see, oh, this is something I wanted to know. So do not limit. The moment you start limiting yourself, you become that ant who sees the puddle as ocean. No, you need to become mighty, much more mightier. That is why I told you, look at sky. When you look at sky, you feel the mightiness because every day you cannot go to fetch your own ocean to get the energy. So look up at the sky, get that energy. And again, while concluding, I'll come to the same thing. The puddle in me bows down to the ocean in you because I still have to learn. When it comes to my learning, it is still limited to that puddle because there is again mightiest thing I have to learn and learn from each one of you. So that was all from me. I want each one of you to keep on packing your toolbox and use the tool at the right time. Do not forget that for pre-primary, this touch is so very important. The warmth is so very important, but this touch doesn't mean that you will blindly let anyone touch the child and you will not see that. Everything is important. And the trust is so very important. When the child puts their trust on you, when the parents put their trust on you, adaptability, I think we are the best example of adaptability now. The way we have adapted to this situation, we have again made our toolbox more strong. Each and every one needs to have a different toolbox, because I cannot pack your toolbox. You cannot pack my toolbox. My toolbox will depend upon my way of thinking. Your toolbox will depend upon your way of thinking. And what we can do, we can collaborate. And I can take few things from your toolbox. You can take few things from my toolbox. And then you see how mighty our toolbox is. And together with these kind of show, what Bela and Amrita are doing, ABCD, they are bringing the best of speakers from everywhere and providing us one tool daily. Trust me, those who are seeing all the episode, once this series will get over, your toolbox will be too huge. It will become a big trunk. And I think it will be a treasure trove. And that is what is learning. And again, that won't be infinity, because that will be a sum total of, say, 20 episodes, 30 episodes, 50 episodes. You are way beyond that. And your brain can take way beyond what is needed. So that was from my side, from a small puddle approach to the ocean approach. Yes, we use many words. So every time you have to use new word to come out of the box. Otherwise, it could have been very simple, from fixed mindset to growth mindset, or from small to big, or from limited to infinity. But then you have to think, how are you packing your toolbox? I packed my toolbox with puddle and ocean today. So that is how you have to keep on packing your box with new words, new vocabulary, and new analogies. That is how we move ahead. So that's all from me, Bela and Amrita. So I hope
lovely session. Lovely. We're getting good comments from everybody. Superb session, excellent. And no, I'm sure I'm really good not to everybody.
I'm not
are there any questions I want to know?
Yes. And Jyotsna, I'm not the ocean of knowledge. I'm still the puddle of knowledge. And the journey is going on, as we all have so many puddles in our
all of
life.
Us are growing from that puddle to the ocean.
Yes.
And, you know, actually, yes, what you said was so beautiful, because it's making us all reflect. All of us are thinking, what do we already have? What is it that we need to put in? I can see my toolbox and I can see missing elements. So it's so nice that we are all collaborating with each other, partnering with each other, helping each other to, you know, fill each other's toolboxes. Beautiful.
So that,
right?
That is what the beauty of everything. I mean, all the learners who are watching your show, every day they are getting a new tool. So you are doing such a wonderful job by letting educators grow. It's you who have taken them. I mean, you have dragged them out of the puddle to go to the mighty ocean to become the lighthouse. So you have already started that journey.
Right.
And in that journey, every episode is making them pack their toolbox, which is becoming mightier and mightier. And I'll wait for it to become a big trunk so that we will have a lot of tools.
Thank
to
you
share
so
with
much. We need well wishes. But Bela, isn't that basically our intention? Our intention is only that
of course,
we transform
totally.
The face of society, of education. Yes.
Yes.
And thank you, because we have experts like you coming over here. You know,
I swear, really.
Everybody.
Really great insight.
Somebody has to start. So you started, and what you did, you did not go from the side of the puddle. You jumped in that puddle. That is what is needed. So all the beautiful audience, jump, enjoy. Live that moment. Do not go from the side that, oh, my shoes will get dirty or my feet will get wet. It's okay. That is the experience that you have to take. I mean, that is why I said that, okay, head, hand, heart, we spoke about that. Dancing feet are equally important.
Very true.
Thank you.
So my audience, do you have any questions for Seema? Any questions, please put them in the question answer box, please. If not, then we will call it a day. Let me see.
I think everything was so explicit that I think everyone's questions are answered.
Beautifully explained.
Yeah, beautifully explained.
Because the audience was so receptive. I could see, I mean, throughout they were writing. And if I could put you in the mode of self-introspection, wherein maybe after this session, you will ask rhetorical question to yourself, then this session is a success, because we have to analyze. Where are we? and where do we have to go? It's very important. You need to know your journey. Once you will know your journey, if your path is clear, you can then make others' path clear. If your path, there's a lot of fog in your path, how are you going to become the lighthouse for others? So do not forget, you have to become the lighthouse for everyone. So from my side, Bela and Amrita, thank you so much for giving this opportunity.
Let us thank you, Seema. Let me thank you first. Thank you for being on the ABCD show. I myself have learned so much. You won't believe it. I've taken notes on my phone while you were talking. So that's really going to help us. I loved your lighthouse idea. Love your toolbox idea. And I love one thing that you said. Look beyond. Look above. Look up. Look around and everywhere. And go beyond what is needed in life. So I really took so much back from your talk today. And I'm sure I'm going to pack my toolbox once again with a lot more things shared by all of us. Thank you so much, Seema, for being here with us. And really, hats off.
Thank you so much. It was such a wonderful evening. I mean, it's lovely to read all the comments that are coming. And both of you are such beautiful powerhouse of energy. You bring so much of positive energy. I mean, so the screens are oozing out of energy. So I think that energy is passed to me also. And I could do justice to the topic.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. It was lovely having you here.
Thank you.
And thank you, audience.
Bye-bye, the audience. For being here
always
with us.
Taking a little break for the new year. Yes. We know all of you are going to be very busy on Christmas. So next Wednesday, we don't have a show and we'll inform you about the next show after that. Bye-bye.
Yeah. We meet straight in January now. Bye, everyone. See you next time. And have a lovely, lovely new year. Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Happy New Year from the ABCD show.